Henry McNeal Turner was born February the 1st, 1834, in Newberry Courthouse, South Carolina. While Turner was young, his father passed, and as the firstborn child, he was left to be the man of the house. As an adolescent, Turner worked in cotton fields alongside enslaved people and held a job as a blacksmith. However, he had envisioned himself as a minister and began to teach himself to read with help from people within the community. By the time he was 15, Turner had read the entire Bible 5 times and had trained himself to memorize lengthy passages of scripture. He attended revival services with his mother and would later join the Methodist Church in Abbeville, South Carolina. At the age of 19, he became a licensed preacher and traveled throughout the South preaching to integrated audiences. In 1856, he married Eliza Peacher, the daughter of a wealthy African American house builder in Columbia, South Carolina. In 1858, he joined the African Methodist Episcopal Church and was assigned to the AME mission in Baltimore, Maryland. While there, he attended Trinity College and gained his first form of formal education. Turner studied Latin, Greek, Hebrew, and theologian. And in 1862, he became an ordained minister and took the role as pastor of the Union Bethel Church in Washington, D.C. During the Civil War, Abraham Lincoln commissioned Turner to the office of chaplain in the Union Army, making him the first black chaplain in any branch of military. In this capacity, he also became a war correspondent, writing many articles for the Christian Recorder newspaper about the trials and tribulations of the 1st Regiment U.S. Colored Troops. When the Civil War ended, he found himself assigned to the Freedmen's Bureau in Georgia as Army chaplain. However, Turner soon resigned from his chaplaincy, mainly because of prejudice and racism. After leaving the military, Turner turned his attention to politics. During the period of Reconstruction and while working with the Freedmen's Bureau, Turner became a Republican Party organizer and helped recruit and organize black voters throughout Georgia. He helped establish the first Republican State Convention and assisted in drafting a new Georgia State Constitution. He was later elected to the Georgia State Legislature. However, any excitement that Turner or black people in general had for ushering in a new day after the Civil War disappeared quickly when white members of the state legislature voted to disqualify blacks from holding elected office. After Turner's removal from the Georgia State Legislature, Turner became United States Postmaster in Macon, Georgia, the first black to ever hold that position. He also held the position as Customs Inspector in Savannah, Georgia, which he held for several years. Eventually, he resigned due to increasing demands of the church. After his resignation, Turner focused his efforts on building the AME Church in the South, and by 1876, he became publications manager for the AME Church. This allowed him to travel to all districts and meet the pastors and leaders of local churches. During the 4 years he served as publications manager, he developed a following that led to his election as one of the bishops of the church. As bishop, Turner had a national platform on which to support his ideas on race, politics, lynchings, and other issues of the day. However, as racism became more of an issue for blacks, Turner increasingly became a proponent of the Back to Africa movement. During the first decade of the 20th century, he edited 2 newspapers, The Voice of Missions and The Voice of the People. He also served as chair of the board for Morris Brown College from 1896 to 1908 and kept a busy schedule up until the end of his life. Henry McNeal Turner's life was guided by faith. He was a minister, politician, and bishop of the AME Church and is seen as one of the most influential African Americans in the late 19th century.